today when you're meeting in groups, we're gonna practice comparing fractions, okay? When you're not meeting with me, you will be practicing comparing fractions as well as your map skill of coordinate graphing. Green group, you're gonna start with that. You're gonna do 5 through 14. Then you're gonna go on to Khan Academy and you're gonna practice comparing with same denominators. Then you will meet with me.
The second strategy in optimizing time is about mixing up whole group, small group, and individual activities during a class period. What this does is allows a teacher to be, in essence, more than one place at once, providing different levels of instruction to different students so they can practice the skills and the knowledge that they in particular need.
It allows me to do really quick observations and check in with them and see how they're doing. But then also having these small groups and these whole groups, even having the different activities, it also builds their connection with each other. That's one thing that we've really been struggling on the last few years is having classmates working together and being able to control emotions and share items. So I think allowing them in all of these different aspects, if they're in small group, being able to communicate together. But then they're also using their verbal skills. And a lot of my ESL learners, it's a great way for them to learn from their classmates. We throw in the vocabulary. I love when I hear, I always call it the math talk. I love when I can hear the keywords when they're talking. So when I meet with my group, I can really focus on those kids and what they need. And then the other kids, they're still hitting those skills, but they're learning from each other. And that's what I always tell them. It's not only me, it's also your classmates that you can learn from.